Warm welcome to social sciences class, all my dear young minds. Today we are going to come across agencies. Yesterday we came across organs of UNO, functions of that organs. Apart from that, principles which are based on the formation of UNO and twin aims of UNO. Principles, aim, functions, and different types of organs, six organs of UNO we came across yesterday. These organs will discharge their duties with the help of certain agencies like ILO, WHO, FAO, IBRD, IMF, UNESCO, UNICEF, like this. Today we are going to know about these abbreviated forms. But it, we are going to expand them, right? Apart from that, we are going to come across organs, General Assembly, Security Council, and Veto Power in this medium, right? Now we are going to come across these things, ma'am, right? First, let us know what are the different agencies through which the United Nations organization will be carrying its different socio-economic activities, right? So they are the agencies of UNO, like ILO, WHO, FAO, ILO, WHO, FAO, IBRD, IMF, International Monetary Fund, FAO, UNICEF, UNESCO. Okay. Here, these are the different agencies through which UNO will be carrying its socio-economic activity. Got it? Right. ILO, it is related to the workers' international, it will protect the rights of workers, International Labour Organization, headquarters of ILO and WHO, World Health Organization. It will take care of, WHO will take care of producing, carrying research work and producing different variety of medicines to counter the bacteria and virus which will be a cause for pandemic or epidemic or endemic, right? So that's WHO's duty, and that is ILO International Labour Organization. WHO, World Health Organization. Every year, 7th April is celebrated as World Health Day. But it will be organized by WHO in different parts of the world. ILO, May 1st is celebrated as International Labour Day, right? So in this way, WHO, World Health Organization. FAO, Food and Agriculture Organization, and it will take care about the food grain production around the world, because one of its aim is to provide, to look into the human development, and also it want to make one of the functions of these organs is to make this world free from hunger, starvation, and poverty. As I said, removing poverty and hunger from this world is also one of the basic function of this particular organization. That's why it will be new variety of seeds production, and the countries like Eastern African countries like Ethiopia and Somalia, those people will not have proper agriculture production and so on. Malnutrition, undernourishment leads to the infant deaths, and also people falling prey of vicious diseases and so on. So now, to avoid that, and there is that, because UNO made a human rights charter already in earlier pages, I said 10th December of every year is celebrated as International Human Rights Day. So it believes strongly human rights are essential for decent and dignified life of a human being. So whoever member countries in this particular country are there, all those countries have to adhere to, they have to adhere to the human rights declaration which was made by UNO, and all these members are signatories. They have signed on that we will be abiding by this act, this, and we will protect the rights of every human being in our country. All countries who are members of United Nations, they will be signing. So once they sign, it is the duty of the governments in that particular countries. Here in the civics we use the state, not a state or nation. It is nothing but country, but it most commonly, right? It is the duty of that state to provide that rights to the every human being, where he will live with a happy and comfortable life with freedom, ultimate freedom, and where he can have a decent and dignified life. So the Human Rights Charter was signed by UN by member countries. This declaration or this charter means constitution related to human rights was made in 1948. 10th December 1948, it got introduced in UNO and the member countries got signed. Got it? So that's why 10th December of every year is observed as International Human Rights Day. 1948, 10th December 1948, International Human Rights Charter, Human Rights Charter got signed. Human Rights Charter came into existence. Charter means the constitution related to human rights. UNO is having a separate chapter, that is constitution. Apart from that, for exclusively for human rights, a constitution is made. That is called Human Rights Charter. And in every, it should be there in every police station also. To make every citizen aware who comes to the police station, it should be there, right? Yeah, World Health Organization, Food and Agriculture Organization, none. Food and Agriculture Organization will be taking care of food production and developing the variety of new variety of seeds which can give more yield, but it high yielding variety and so on, right? It will take wherever food price shortage is there, it will try to help with the help of the member countries. Some countries the production may be very much more. In some other countries people are dying with the hunger. So immediately it will pursue. And it will try to bail out that country from that shortage of food grains, and it will save the rest. It will come to the rescue of those people who are suffering with hunger and who are about to lose their lives. Right? Headquarters of FAO is in Rome, Ghana. Rome, capital of Italy. FAO headquarters is in Rome, capital of Italy. And WHO Geneva in Switzerland. See, this is Rome here in Rome in Italy. And Switzerland, Geneva will be very close to France. Very close to France. Got it? Right. Very close to this is Geneva. There, headquarters of ILO and WHO is existing. IBRA, Washington DC, capital of United States of America. And UNICEF, New York, IBRA, Washington DC. Washington DC, District of Columbia. Right. UNICEF. UNICEF have its headquarters at New York. In headquarters of UN only, it is there. And UNESCO Paris, capital of France, here, Paris. Capital of France, UNESCO, capital of, and yes, headquarters of UNESCO is in Paris, capital of France, and the New York capital of, financial capital of United States of America, UNICEF headquarters is there, and expanded. FAO Food and Agriculture Organization, IBA, in an International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, this is popularly called as World Bank. World Bank means IBA, the International Bank for Reconstruction and Development. I think you can write very clearly, this is very clear to you. And IMF, International Monetary Fund. These two are the agencies which will be funding the countries who are in need of some economic help to improve their infrastructure. Infrastructure means to improve their road, transportation. Already I said you, health. transportation, telecommunication, education, health, they all come under the basic requirements or facilities what human beings require or need to carry a decent and dignified life. So it will be trying to provide that financial support. It will extend loans to those countries who are interested in promoting their infrastructure to the next level. But even India, see, after United States of America, China, India is the largest borrower from these financial agencies. Got it? Right? UNICEF. It is there to take care of the children in the world. The United Nations International Children Emergency Fund. Got it? Whenever Ethiopia, Somalia, where children are dying with hunger, you see those children. Almost all, even monkeys are far better than them. Of course, I should not say like that. That means healthy. I'm speaking about. It's not in a mean mind, right? There will be what we can call the spine will be just patched, the skin patched structure we can see without any flesh and muscles because of malnourishment. Even mothers don't have proper food. So they were unable to get proper nutritious food. So for those people, supporting that people also is the task of this UNO. It does it through UNICEF. Yeah, that's why UNICEF will be printing this greeting cards, Nana. And that money, what it gets through in the form of greeting cards, postal stamps, and so on, in these different activities it will be taking. That money it will be spending for the well-being of those children who are deprived of basic amenities in the entire world. Not only Eastern African countries, anywhere when children are not getting proper things, it will be taken care of. UNICEF, United Nations International Children's Emergency Fund. Right. UNESCO, this is the agency which will be taking care of education, scientific development, cultural development or cultural aspects related to member countries in the world. United Nations Education, Scientific and Cultural Organization. This is the organization which will be giving recognition to certain places like Charminar, Taj Mahal or some historical monuments. It will giving a more that heritage site means it should be protected. Maybe Fort of Warangal. So these all are heritage means, so yes, hundreds of years onwards they are existing and they are renowned for their sculpture and engineering skills. Got it? Architectural skills. So protecting them means a duty of the governments existing. So once something is moved as heritage site, it will fund for renovating that and also to sustain that structure. It will be funding us through UNESCO, United Nations, and also it will take care of scientific work also. Got it? Education also. Got it? Around the world. So in this way, you got the agencies. ILO, WHO have their headquarters in Geneva. Geneva is in Switzerland. Geneva, G-E-N-E-V-A. And FAO have at Rome. IBRDA, IBM are having it in Washington, D.C. UNICEF, New York is the headquarters. And Paris is the headquarters of UNESCO. Got it, Nana? That is capital of France, Paris is. And New York is financial capital of the United States of America. If you see to the what we can call east of America in Pacific Ocean, it will be very close to that. Atlantic Ocean. I beg your pardon. Atlantic Ocean to the east of America. Atlantic Ocean is there. North America, North Atlantic. South America, South Atlantic. Between Europe and North America, North Atlantic is there. Between Africa and South America, South Atlantic is there. Put together, Atlantic Ocean will be flowing from top to bottom. But it, so this particular city in New York is there in the eastern coast of United States of America. If you see the world map, you can get it. But it, and Paris. Paris is capital of France. UNESCO's headquarters in Paris. This is about these organizations. Apart from that, yesterday I mentioned one more agency, one more organ, that International Court of Justice. Its headquarters is at The Hague, Netherlands here. See, you see, this is Netherlands, Belgium, Germany, Belgium, and between this Germany and Belgium, we have a country called Netherlands, which is also called as Holland. which is also called as Holland, and the people of this country are called Dutch. Dutch people, they are also good colonial powers. Got it? They are the first, they are the people to step into South Africa first, which is renowned for diamonds and gold. And they came early than the British to India after Portugal, Portuguese, right?
So this is Netherlands or Holland. Their people are called Dutch.
In that country, the Hague is there. Their international court of justice (ICJ) is existing. It will be looking into the disputes that arise between country and country. For example, India and Pakistan confronted for a project on the river Sindh. What it Indus? What it Bagliar project? And according to the agreement between India and Pakistan, India have right to use certain water related to the tributaries of that Sindh river. But what Pakistan stated is, India is dragging water from, by building this project Bagliar, India is trying to drag water from Sindh river. So it is injustice done by India to me, unfair, unjust, and it is strongly protested against, and it went to the International Court of Justice. Of course, International Court of Justice carried the investigation, or trials were there for several years, and finally couple of years back, International Court of Justice crystal clearly made it out. India is not using any single droplet belonging to Pakistan, allocated to Pakistan. It is purely sticked on to the limit what it was permitted. So no need of this dispute. Don't try to poke into the matter of that Bagliar, was the saying of the International Court of Justice. It was a big success to India. One more project is also going on. Of course, hurdles, even that is started raising a point towards that of Pakistan. Always they want to poke into the matter. But it, because they don't care on the development of the people. And those people, rulers who don't want to develop the people, who never want people to think about development, they always try to raise the sentiments in the name of region, language, or religion, cultural aspects, linguist aspects, or slangs, and all these things they try to use. Only focuses political mileage and political gain. That country always, they never think about the poverty of the people existing over there. Malnutrition going on, undernutrition going on, but it subhuman conditions prevailing in different parts of that country. But they always want to divert the people in the name of religion. So such rulers are there from the beginning of its independence. Pakistan got segregated or separated from India. It is experiencing that. Let it be. We don't want to involve in the fate. We have sympathy to my fellow Indians once upon a time. That is, Pakistanis are none other than once upon a time our brothers only. But it 74 years back, right? So we have a sympathy, that's all. What we can do? Nothing. So we are already having our own problems to think about, right? India is there, right? So this is what done. This is what the content related to the agencies of UNO. But it UNO's role is not only limited to the protecting the international peace or preserving the international peace, but also it's having a big role in promoting the human development in the world. For that purpose, it is having 6 organs, apart from that, several agencies. Not only these are important agencies, that's why I mentioned, and mentioned in the textbook. Of course, 2-3 are not mentioned here. In globalization, IPR is mentioned, but it, so there again you will be asking, that's why I made it clear, NIRO, right? So now I'll move to the organs of UNO, important organs, General Assembly, and this one, what we can call Security Council, right? Yeah, no, Security Council, General Assembly are very important. General Assembly. Yesterday, I explained about General Assembly. In all the member countries will be there existing in the UNO as a member of this particular. Now, page number 175, 78, I think. photograph of general assembly is given second time. Photographs, pictures will be given, and you are supposed to write 2 marks answer. You have to analyze and write the 2 marks answer or 4 marks answer also. Be careful. A picture of it is given. Even emblem of UNO is given. That all things will come in revision, right? So general assembly or internal examinations will be asking so all things. So to make you perfect, even such questions come, you can counter, right? General assembly. It is the body. It is the organ of UNO, which will be giving birth to its members. That is, every member is given allotted a seat. Got it? They got allotted a seat. 193 seats will be there in this particular assembly. There will be a secretary general. Got it? Secretary general here. Guterres, Antonio Guterres from Portugal is the present secretary general of UNO. One of the member countries will take the role of. From fellows belonging to one of the member country will become secretary in general. Okay, secretary general now present is Antonio Guterres. He will present the meetings. He will conduct the meetings in this general assembly. Antonio Guterres. Yeah, some Guterres somewhere spelling here and there, maybe there, and later we can come across, right? Antonio Guterres is the name. You have to remember, you can remember Antonio. If we even final exam, present of Secretary General, they ask Antonio Guterres, AG, you remember that, sir. You can go somewhere. General Assembly, 193 members will be there. I said, you know, in 2011, the last country joined this General Assembly is South Sudan. South Sudan is Africa, but it North African country. Below Egypt, if you see, Sudan will be there. That Sudan got divided into North Sudan and South Sudan, got it? So, because of the internal differences between the southern people and the northern people, got it? Such things happened in India also, certain demands were there that we will come across in 18th chapter or 18th chapter. So, that got divided from Sudan got divided into two, and that South Sudan was given immediately membership in General Assembly. Got it? So, the 193 countries will be meeting at least once. General body meeting will be there once in a year. Got it, Anna? Mostly before 24th October, the birthday of this body, UNO, on 20th October or 21st October, like that it will be conducted. And if any emergency situation is there, special meetings will also be there in a year. But at least once in a year, must it be here to meet. And it will look into the happenings in the world between the different countries. Got it? So, like that. And in this house, if any decisions have to be made related to other aspects other than war and peace, remaining issues, political, social, economic issues in the world will be discussed here only. Got it? And resolutions will be passed by General Assembly related to that with majority members' support. 193 countries are there, 100 countries support, then only it will be a resolution. What is a resolution? Any decision made in written form is a resolution, that's it. Got it, Ra? If you generally we make decisions in the mind, if it is made in written form and everyone signs members, that's nothing but resolution. Resolution get passed, means a decision made by the majority members got passed, right? So, resolutions will be passed related to social and economic aspects. And related to war and peace, there is one body called Security Council, very powerful. Security Council. It may be asked for 4 marks also. When it is asked for Security Council, asked for 4 marks, you have to write even the body's veto power and so on. Right. Now you are going to learn. Security Council. It is one of the important organ of UNO. Very, very important. It will make decisions related to war and peace. What it? Going very important. It will make decisions related to war and peace. This is Security Council. In this Security Council, there will be 15 permanent members. Sorry, 15 members out of that 193 countries. Out of these, 5 are permanent members, 10 are non-permanent members. And happy to say is, once again India got an opportunity to become a non-permanent member in Security Council. From 2021 January, India is going to be one of the non-permanent members. It was there earlier, several times it was there. But again we got the opportunity, and many countries in the world were there at the back of India taking the membership in, that getting the membership in that Security Council. India is a non-permanent member. Actually, India is thinking of becoming a permanent member, but the idiotic China, which is lying to the east of India, actually we supported them in becoming permanent member in UN Security Council. But when other world was opposing them, we supported and we strongly gave our support to our, being a neighboring country, we loved it and we gave support to our fellow Asian country, one of the big country along like us. We supported it when it was struggling for permanent membership. But now that fellow is trying to object, raising objection, it is gathering strength against India to, so that India will never become a permanent member. So it's very variable aspect. But even though India got an opportunity to become a non-permanent member, every non-permanent member will have a term of 2 years. Permanent members, permanent, they don't have any term. So, 5 non-permanent members. What are the 5 permanent members? ABCFR. ABCFR. What are the ABCFR? A for America, United States of America. B for Britain or England. B for Britain or England. C for China. F for France. R for Russia. R for Russia. ABCFR. ABC alphabets. ABC alphabets. AB. A America, B Britain. A America means United States of America. B Britain means England. C China. F France. R Russia. These 5 are permanent members. And these 5 fellows will enjoy a power. What is that power? Veto power. What is this veto? This is the word that God derived from. This is the word that God derived from Latin. Latin is spoken in Italy. Got it? So, the from Latin, this word got derived veto. And Sonia Gandhi's motherland, once upon a time, right? Once upon a time, actually she belongs even to, she's the origin of Italian origin only, isn't it? Right. So, veto. This word got derived from Latin. What it means in Latin is, I forbid. I forbid means I stop it. Forbid means stop. I reject to say no. But it, and this veto power is given to, where from we got this veto word? Veto word got derived from Latin. Latin word, which means I forbid. I forbid. Which means I forbid. I forbid means I stop. When we stop, when we don't like something, we try to stop. I reach it. Got it? So once permanent, any of permanent member uses this veto power, automatically remaining 4 permanent members and 10 non-permanent members, even they are ready to make any resolution, pass any resolution, that will be suspended. Even pass a resolution will be suspended. So using this veto power, most of the times these superpowers, very particularly United States of America, see here what happened, you see two are communist countries, Russia and China, and America and Britain, France are capitalistic countries, is it a democratic and communist countries, and these are once upon a time, not now, these all things went up to 1991, now it is a unipolar world, even not we can say unipolar world. There are competent forces like India and China which are challenging this particular United States of America. What it? Japan economically, right? So there are certain countries, okay. But after World War II, up to 1991, it is a bipolar world mostly dominated by USA and USSR. Right, that's why that only turned a cause for Cold War, which we are going to learn in coming videos, right? So, yeah, these three are sympathetic towards capitalism. These two are some, maybe yes, China and Russia are sympathetic towards communism. So, because of their involvement, several conflicts seems to arise all the time. That is a headache to UN. And using this power, they made UN to dance according to their tunes. Got it? They made UN to dance according to their tunes. Dictates, it have to follow their dictates. If four countries are one side and other one country is introducing veto, the decision is nullified. Security Council can't go ahead and take action against any aggressive country. China's friend is there, someone explains. And that fellow is doing some mischief. Security Council want to take an action. China introduces veto. Go on. Or some friend of Britain is doing something wrong. Then China want to introduce, or Russia want to introduce a veto. They are passing a resolution. Immediately they will be using veto. The decision made by majority members in Security Council, that 10 non-permanent and this remaining 4 permanent 40 members made a decision, that got nullified. That got nullified, it got to implement that resolution. So they made it to act according to their dictates or diktats. Most of the time it was a hostage in the hands of, UN was a hostage in the hands of, hostage means being in the control of. Bandi, Bandi Gamarata, got it? So, it is under control, under the hostage of, a word is used, hostage in England, next slide. Yeah, taking under control. It is controlled by whom? These quite permanent members. Of course, the UNO, creation of UNO also made these countries to maintain self-control and moderation. Moderation and self-control, they were forced to because of the formation of UN, that is a partial success of it. And also these countries were made to realize you are the, what is your role in protecting the world peace, better understand, in making them better understanding or regarding their role in protection and preserving of world peace, UN was successful there. But because of some extreme powers like veto over them, the things went, several wars occurred in the world. There in that area it was a failure on behalf of UNO in controlling that wars. Because of involvement of these five permanent members, one or other. One case one will be involving, other case other will be involving. But in case of socio-economic progress, Nana, to a great extent it was successful. What it did? Improving the literacy rate in the world, took utmost care, providing quality food to the foodless, and also quality medicines, and countering the epidemics, pandemics, endemics. It was very successful in the past history, almost 79 years after its inception. So, this is what about the UNO. And I think every, whatever the point is important, I reiterated, I was repeating it, saying about it twice or thrice. Please note down in your running notes. Thank you all. Tomorrow we will be coming across Cold War. Cold War occurred in the three forms. One is proxy wars and military alliances. Apart from that, arms and space race. Three are there, probably two videos too. We may conclude, or three videos we may be concluding in them. Very important. Please go through them every day and make your notes. Have a happy time, children. See you.